Hello, this is the second video in a series on a particular problem, fun problem in combinatorics, the problem of counting the one by one square edges which compose an n by n grid. And the previous video focused on the case of a chessboard 8x8 and came up with a formula that, as far as I knew, during to the end of the past video, was valid for at least grids that had an even number for each side, such as 2x2, 4x4, etc. And before I go any further, this is an actual subject. This is a combinatorics book, since it's one I studied from. It's an older combinatorics book by now, but still a good one. Well, here's the general formula that was given, I believe, even in the previous video study to count one by one square edges in an n by n grid. We have the general formula 2 times n times the quantity n plus 1. And after the first video was over, I did a little more figuring and discovered that this would work not just for square grids where each side is an even number, such as 2, 4, etc., but it works for any n by n grid. It's not, in other words, odd numbers such as 3 by 3, 5 by 5 grids, and so forth. They'll work also. And later in this video, we're going to find this formula handy, which most everybody who studied combinatorics knows. To sum the digits from 1 through n, this little formula does the trick. N times the quantity, n plus 1, all divided by 2. Now, to justify this formula, I saw that there are several different ways of counting. What you do in combinatorics is count. There are several different ways of counting chessboard edges that result in our general formula. I call them plans. Here's plan A. In plan A, we're going to count n edges together in a row, west to east. In other words, something like here's a top row here going from west to east. And we're going to do this n plus 1 times because there's a bottom row. Well, I say on the card here going north to south, there's a top row, a next to top row, and so forth. You can see there are 9 of them. And we go through this twice, you see, because we do this once for covering all the horizontal edges and once for covering all the vertical edges. So 2 times n times the quantity n plus 1, that gives our general formula, does it not? Next, there's another way of going about this. Plan B. Here, what we do is we count an echelon of edges sorted in order 1, 2, 3, going up to 8. Let me demonstrate one of these echelons going from large, smallest to large, north to south. Here's 1, here's 2, here's 3, here's 4, and so forth. And we come to the bottom row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So remember that footnote formula on this slide here. Whenever we count an echelon of edges like that, we can use this formula here. And we go through this 4 times for each direction, north, south, east, and west, going from smallest to largest in the directions north, south, east, and west. So 4 times this is going to figure out to, since 4 divides by 2, and that leaves you with 2 times n times the quantity n plus 1 once more, does it not? Now, this is kind of the one that takes most invention, and I think I used this plan, a form of this plan, in the first video. But what I'm talking about here is in the grid there are how many of these little 1 by 1 squares? Of course, there are n squared of them. Well, let's multiply n squared by 4, because each 1 by 1 square has 4 edges. But the trouble is that counts some of those edges more than once. So we can see, however, that we have counted all the edges of the perimeter exactly once and no more. So let's temporarily subtract those out. That's my step here, subtracting a 4n, a quantity 4 times n. After this subtraction, we have only edges that got counted twice each. So what we do next is the quantity thus far we divide by 2, and we would be incomplete unless we included those perimeter edges. So that we do as our last step, we add 4 times n. And I have a separate slide here to show you how that all works out. Kind of 4 terms here, and you see, I'm not going to go over it in detail, but you see that putting them all together and simplifying by simple figuring, you get our general formula again. 2 times n plus 1. And finally, one neat thing about our plan B, counting an echelon of edges sorted in order 4 times, that really helps you remember what the general formula is. Really, it's more clear if you look at the slide for plan A, if I can find it again. Oh yeah, here it is. Consider that This is saying that what you got to do to count all the edges is twice n times n plus 1. And half of these then, of course, is n times n plus 1. And just counting horizontal lines here, for example, you see that is just two of these echelons fitted together, increasing in order as you go from north to south. That's one echelon, and then increasing in order as you go from south to north. And so, leaving out the two, since we're only doing it once, n times n plus 1, that helps you remember that half of that is the half of that product, that is, n times n plus 1, is going to be the, half of that is going to be the formula for summing up the useful summation of the whole numbers 1 plus 2, etc., up till n. Well, till next time, and other fun problems in math.